Nänabushu Obscenely Jests with His Grandmother by Marie Syrette. Read by Frank Blissett. And now they say that once while Nänabushu was traveling about on the run, never did he come to a halt. And once they say that when he was running along, Nänabushu was addressed by his grandmother, saying, "My grandson, I wish to go out," he was told. And Nänabushu, in reply, said, "Simply lean aside with your buttocks," he said to his grandmother. "Nay, my grandson," she said to him, "I have need of relief," she said to her grandson. "Then do it there," he said to his grandmother. Well, it was so that the old woman relieved herself at the time in that position. And so again the old woman said to her grandson, "Oh, my grandson," she said to him, "by the edge of the woods do pass along as you run. I wish to get hold of something on the way to wipe myself at the anus," he was told. "With your elbow wipe your anus," he said to his grandmother. And it was true that the old woman wiped herself at the anus with her elbow. Thereupon again the old woman said to her grandson, "Into the thick woods do you go, for, as I go, I wish to clean my elbow with the limbs," she said to her grandson. Whereupon again Nänabushu said to his grandmother, "Lick it with your tongue," he said to her. Well, it was the same again, for she licked her elbow with her tongue, whereupon the old woman said to her grandson, "Oh, my grandson, just raise your head a little." "Why?" said Nänabushu. "I want to spit," said the old woman. Nänabushu said, "Swallow it." That was Nänabushu Obscenely Jests with His Grandmother by Marie Syrette, read by Frank Blissett.